السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين ولتكن منكم أمة يدعون إلى الخير ويأمرون بالمعروف وينهون عن المنكر وأولئك هم المفلحون وما كان المؤمنون لينفروا كافة فلولا نفر من كل فرقة منهم طائفة ليتفقهوا في الدين ولينذروا قومهم إذا رجعوا إليهم لعلهم يحذرون
رحیم حضور says that these verses which I have just recited, the first verses from Surah Al-Imran, and the translation of that is that there should be a community among you, those who are always asking the people to come to goodness and give them the good instruction and stop them from evils, and these are the people who are going to be successful. And the second verse is from Surah Tawbah. The translation of that is that it's not possible for mu'min believers that all of them, they should all together go out. But why is it not possible that some group of among them should go out so that they should have the knowledge of religion and then warn their people when they turn to them so that in this way they may be saved from the destruction? Huzur says that in these verses, as you have seen, Allah Almighty has mentioned about that group of people who, those who devote their lives for the sake of religion and establish the goodness and stop the people from evils and spend their whole life in the propagation of Islam. By the grace of Allah, Hazur says that in the Ahmadiyya Jamaat, for the sake of religion, the system of devoting the lives for religion in one form or the other, from the time of the promised Messiah alayhi salatu wasalam, the system is in practice there. And in second Khilafat, there was more regularity in this system, and formally the devotion of life, the system of devotion, devoting the life and the bonds or the forms, they were filled for this purpose. And that system started for religious education. The system of Jamia Ahmadiyya was further organized. The missionaries, they started to be sent to foreign countries, they did very meritorious job in the field of tabligh. And by the grace of Allah, in tabligh and tarbiyat activities, they got their identification as such. And this work, by the grace of Allah, is continuous till today. And the missionaries in various countries, they are busy in performing this duty and task. These missionaries and Murabiyan and the Mollameen who are in this in Pakistan, apart from Pakistan and India, now the people from various nationalities, and they are also participating in it, particularly the missionaries in African countries and the Mollameen. They are taking part in this system in large number, and also in Indonesia. Allah Almighty enable all of them with full devotion and loyalty, enable them to serve this cause. In the system of the devotion of life, there is another group as well. Not only the missionaries are there, the doctors and the teachers are also there. They are also serving the cause of the community. Anyway, with the expansion in the needs of the Jamaat and in the expansion in the field of tabligh and also in other areas of service, the expansion is there. The need is more. Wherever the need is there of devoted missionaries and the doctors, it's expanding. As the expansion is taking place there, and the the requirements are expanding and increasing, and the system of Ahmadiyyat is increasing and expanding, and the people of the world, they are joining more and more into the fold of Ahmadiyyat. Those people who are the devotees of life and those who have religious knowledge, a greater need of these people is being felt, who can perform the duties of tabligh and tarbiyat, who can perform the duty in these two sections of tabligh and tarbiyat. As it is quite evident from these verses, Allah Almighty says that each and every member of the community, it is not possible for each and every person to be busy in the work of tabligh and tarbiyat. So therefore, this group of people, the special group, who is specially they should perform this duty in particular. While in other places, the responsibility of every member of the Ummah is included there, that they have to invite the people to goodness and stop from evil and preach the message of Islam in a general way. But Allah Almighty has also mentioned that because this worldly system, it is very essential to carry it on, to carry it out. So therefore, those people who get busy in that, they cannot devote full time. And secondly, everybody does not have the temperament or the style that he can perform this duty in a very good way, the duty of tabligh and tarbiyat. And all members of the Muslim Ummah, they also do not have that perception and understanding of religion, which is very essential for a muballigh and a missionary and a murabbi to have. And moreover, all the people cannot be given this training in an organized way. So therefore, there should be a group, there should be a small community who learn the religion under special arrangements, and the commandments of Allah Almighty, the do's and don'ts, they should be fully aware of that. and the profound wisdom should be understood, and that should be spread in the people. MashaAllah, by the grace of Allah, there are a lot of people in the Jamaat who, according to their own personal desire and keenness, apart from their secular education, they have a very profound knowledge of religion, and understanding is there among those people. But most of the time, their other engagements are such which stands in their way and devoting their full time for this purpose. Anyway, Allah Almighty says that for the job, religious duties, there should be a group of devotees of life. And then, as Islam is a universal religion, is a global message, therefore from each community, that is to say that from each group, from each walk of life, and from each branch and section, there should be some people of different type. Different type of people should be there. There should be a community of those different people, and then, in order to further expanding it further, that from each nation there should be some people who learn the religion, acquire the religious knowledge, and then spread it further to the people. From each qaum, from each nation, and from each community, and their temperaments and their behavior and the attitude, their way of doing things are different. So according to that variety, the method of tabligh should also be adopted. Similarly, it will be much easier to do tabligh, and also the tarbiyat, it will become much easier. Anyway, this guidance, Allah Almighty gave this guidance that there should be a group of believers, of the mu'mins, who should be performing the duty of tabligh and tarbiyat. And then it is mentioned that from each nation, from each group of people, there should be some people, so that this job should become further easy. So in the Jamaat Ahmadiyya, according to this principle, for the sake of religion, the system of devoting life is well established. And as I said, various nations and various sections of the community, the people from them, they are becoming a part of this system. And this is happening, this is a continuous thing. And as I said, with the expansion of Jamaat needs, in this number, there is a need to increase this number as well, with the expansion of the requirements. And this need will continue to increase in future. For the time being, it is not only required for this time, but in future this need is going to increase further. Hadhrat Khalifatul Masih Rabe Rahimahullah Ta'ala ne, foreseeing this need under the guidance from Allah Almighty, he started the scheme of Waqf-e-Nau. And the very first brick was based on taqwa, the righteousness, and he launched this appeal to the parents that instead of devoting the children when they grow up, and then they devote their life for the sake of religion and then offer themselves directly, the parents, having the keen desire to serve religion and having firmness in righteousness, they should devote their children even before their birth. They should offer their children even before the children are born. And like the mother of Hadhrat Maryam, they should announce that Rabbi inni nazartu laka ma fi batni muharraran fataqabbal minni, that O my Allah, whatever is in my uterus, I have devoted it for you and made him free to offer for the needs and the requirements of religion, and I have delivered him from the worldly requirements. So now you please accept this from me. So with this prayer, particularly the mothers, they offer their children for this very purpose and offer them to the Khalifa of the time, then it becomes one of their great responsibility that they should look after the tarbiyat and the training of the children in such a way that those children in the way of Allah, they should be spending their life